Hi, I'm Scott Hanselman, and I'm here to give you a taste of what you can do with Azure Storage. Blobs, tables, queues, and files in Azure, whether you're a developer, a DevOps person, huge enterprise, or a small independent, Microsoft Azure is a hybrid cloud that'll handle pretty much anything you can throw at it. Now, in the web-based Azure portal, let's create a storage account. I don't have any accounts yet, so I'll quickly create one with add. Now, the name of the storage account needs to be globally unique and all lowercase, so no symbols. It's kind of like having your own custom URL like hanselman.core.windows.net. There's two types of storage accounts. There's general purpose and blob. General purpose can be used for blob and also file, queue, and table scenarios that'll be leveraged by your applications, VM disks, and other scenarios. Blob accounts support more advanced cool versus hot access patterns for when you have different storage needs and different usage patterns. We'll stick with general purpose for this. Now, performance-wise, we'll leverage the default, which is great for this demo. It's backed by hard disk drives, but premium storage accounts are backed by SSDs. So you'll want to consider premium for your production environments, including disks for supporting high-performance workloads like SQL. There's a number of options around replication and redundancy, so you'll want to read the docs to understand the different options based on your needs. I'll hit Pin to Dashboard and then Create. And here's my brand new general-purpose storage account. Now from here, I could start using blobs, files, tables, and queues. I can access diagnostics, explore the activity logs, all available from this resource menu. Now this storage account is general purpose, so I can use it for lots of different things, but in this video, I'm going to use it for a file share. I'm going to create a mountable storage drive without needing to install or maintain a server, and I only have a few minutes to do it, so what'll I do? I'll click on Files and create a file share. Call it Hansel Files. I'll give it a small quota and hit Create. This share is created very quickly, so I'll upload a couple of files. So now let's connect to this file share from Windows. I could also connect from Linux or Mac. I have this net use command, and I'm going to map the Z drive on my local machine up to the new file share in Azure. But I need a storage account access key. You're going to want to keep this a secret. Don't go and put it in a video or something. Copy that access key to the command line and hit enter. You'll need to make sure that your ports are open and that your firewall understands what you're trying to do, but now I've just mapped the Z drive up into Azure, and there's a file. There's a file right there. If I wanted, I could use the Microsoft Azure Storage Explorer. It lets me work with Azure Storage from any platform. Here, this application lets me open up that storage account. Look at that file share. There's a file. I'm going to hit upload. And from this cross-platform application, upload a picture directly into Azure. Now there's two files there. I'll switch back over to the command prompt and type dir. And there's that second file. I'm accessing that exactly with the native file system APIs. So if you're a developer who's looking to move your on-prem applications that depend on these native APIs, you can leverage file shares in Azure to easily lift and shift your apps to the cloud. Can this be done from within Linux? Let's find out. And there's my files. So now I've mounted my Azure file storage directly from within a Linux machine. I've got simultaneous access from both of these machines. So if you're a developer, you can use the same storage accounts for blobs, tables, and queues. Be sure to check out all the useful links in the Azure documentation.